face voice. An overdub has no choice. She cannot rejoice. Wanting to be, to hear and to see. Cry to the sky. The pompous is laughing. This is laughing. Goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye,
please welcome back to the stage, Michael Nesmith.
I'm going to take control of a few things up here right now with the music, because I was mining the Monkees catalog over the last few months getting ready for this tour. I realized this is a farewell tour. Easy does it. And things are happening tonight that will never happen again. You know that. Stop it. It's not maudlin. It's not sad. It just is. And it happens to all of us in our families and in our fandom and everything. And I was thinking about the Monkees music. And how can I write to this moment? Maybe not this moment, but a moment like it. When we were all 6 years old, 8 years old. Suddenly inside this Monkees music, which seemed at the first pass frivolous, maybe even fatuous, maybe even vapid, who knew? But it was music. And it is music, and it sang to us. And I remember, as you say it, and I remember at that moment realizing how much is buried in these songs. That lonely moment in our basements, listening to the Monkees albums alone, because you didn't want anybody to know you liked them. Oh, we all knew. I said to myself, well, you can relate to this. There are moments of sorrow, and there are moments of deep introspection. It doesn't mean if you're 6 or 8 or 2. It's in us some way. And it would come out silently in those basements and closets in our private spaces. It would come out and it would touch us and it would make us cry. Which is, if you're a kid, hard. You don't even know why you're doing it. And there it is, alive in you, in us. So I tried to write to the moment. Maybe I botched it a little bit, I don't know, but this is it. While I cry. They told me what you'd do if I ever stayed with you. They told me that you laugh while I cry. They told me what you'd say, that you'd turn and walk away and find another place to play.
It's
want to be maudlin about it, but it's a very special night for us. Thank you so much for coming out and holding on to your tickets, you know, for 2 years. It's been a crazy, crazy ride. And we want to thank you. You guys are the ones that make it happen. Thank you so much.
And sent out a call for a keyboard player months ago, and we're staffing up for the tour we're on right now. And so I said, you know, you gotta audition Alex Jules. He's a great keyboard player. He knows his stuff. Bring him in. And I said, All right. So I called Alex up, and he said, oh yeah, I'd like to take a swing at that. I said, all right, come by. And we'll play. He said, Vince, you want me to get special? You want me to do anything? I said, just, you know, Daydream Believer. He says, yeah, I know it. So, okay, no, we'll do that. We'll audition that. So, he came in, he sat down, and he played Daydream Believer. He did a great version of it, great technique. We sat there and silence after it was done. I looked at Mick and went, this is the guy. And then, I don't know what overtook me. I just said, Alex, can you play that in a minor key? And he said, yes, I think I can. Listen to the band.